dessert's dessert, right? It's a treat, but we can definitely make it a little better option for you. I know you guys are trying to stick pretty strict, very low sugar. We're going to use a bar of this chocolate, 5 grams of sugar per serving. There's 2.5 servings per container, so what, we got like 12 or 13 grams of sugar in this whole bar. We're actually going to melt this down in a makeshift double boiler, and I'll talk about that here in a minute. And then we're going to toss in coconut and blueberries. Guys know what haystacks are. They're about my favorite kind of chocolate. It's just chocolate and coconut. It looks like little haystacks. We're going to make those, and then we're going to make a version with fresh blueberries. So I don't have a double boiler. It's just a fancy pot that has basically one pot on top of another. I'm just going to put a little bit of water in this. All right. Pretend like I'm not over the messy sink right now. All right, so I've just put about an inch of water in the bottom. This pan's gonna sit right over the top. You don't want to try to cook the chocolate over direct heat, so that's why we're doing this. What will happen is it's going to like burn and stick to the outside edges of the pan. We don't want that. This is gonna let the water underneath come up to a nice gentle boil. It's gonna heat up this pan here, and that's how we're gonna cook our chocolate. So we're actually not cooking it, we're melting it. So I have my 85% dark, and I'm just gonna use this whole bar, so. I'll go ahead and like break each of the pieces in a couple so it melts a little quicker. You can get as creative with this as you want. So we're gonna probably just make some plain haystacks today. If you wanted to put like some heat in it, like some cayenne or sea salt or orange zest, those are all different versions of this you could make. And they're all delicious, so we're just gonna kind of push it around a little bit, let it start to melt. It's gonna take a few minutes for that water underneath to boil, which is what we need to start melting the chocolate. So while that's melting, I'm just gonna prepare the cookie sheet. We're not actually gonna cook these, all right? We're just putting plastic wrap over the top. You could use parchment paper, wax paper, whatever you have. I don't think I'd do foil. I think that would actually, the chocolate would stick to that and you'd get little bits of foil in your haystack, and you definitely don't want that. If you've ever bitten into aluminum foil, my dad made me do it once for just to trick me. He thought it was so funny. I guess it's really bad if you have fillings. I don't, but I had braces at the time, so it's like the metal on metal is terrible. So this is just gonna keep the stuff from sticking to the bottom of the pan, okay? So I've just